Hi guys, Max here, and today we're going to be talking just very quickly about the rewards and the rank rewards when it comes to the Oogie Onslaught leaderboards and dungeons situation. I don't want to go that route where it feels like already like, oh dude, that sounds negative. No, but there is hopefully some constructive criticism on when it comes to how the rewards are being put. So the milestones, let's talk that. Milestones, great job on the milestones. I do think these are great for all the entire players. I want to say kudos there. I mean, we get some of these glowing crystals gives you a chance. You know, if you're progressing, trying to create your account to be a little bit larger, you get a 3-star out of it. I love it. I love the milestones. As we start getting there, the Oogie Boogies crystals, we get a chance of a 5-star. So that's the first crystal. We get Oogie Boogie as a 2-star. So if you don't even have them, you can go ahead and get them as a 2-star. Further down, you're actually going to see him as a 2-star. And then I think there's a 3-star further down. Yeah, further down, there's a 3-star. That's the milestone number 22. But before that, I kind of skipped right over it. There's more Oogie Boogie crystals. And the final stash right there is 5 Oogie Boogie crystals at the end with a chance for you to get a 6-star or any other possible guarding out of it. So I think this is a win, a total win when it comes to the milestone rewards. If you can hit them all and within the event without really having to spend inside the game to refresh, to get some, you know, use your orbs inside. But don't worry, you're also getting some orbs, you know, as a big 65 orbs on the milestone number 18. So, there, I think that is probably the only orbs that I think I saw there. Yeah. Oh, no. Sorry. Milestone number 33. You get to 35 as well. So that, I think the milestones are a great job. And I want to start with a big W and a success when it comes to the event. The only thing where I would say I would improve and change is the rank rewards. So when we look at rank rewards, the number one placement gets a 5-star with a couple of goodies, some signets, 4 Oogie Boogie, 20 of them, some crystals, and some notes to level up your guardian. So rank number 2 to 3 gets a 4-star, rank number 4 to 10 gets a 3-star, and then rank 100, all the way from 11 to 100, get the remaining. And I think we're going to stop there because then it's percentage-based. But because this is a brand new event, and if you look at my total points, I have 67,000 points as of right now, the recording. The event's not over. I think we got like about 24 hours left in the event, so an entire day to add more points to this. And with 67,000 points, I did use some refreshing. We're going to call it refreshing. I don't know if that's a proper name for it, to basically get more energy inside the dungeons to explore more and finish it. To get more points, I had the multiplier as well. So, I was shooting for the top 100. I just wanted to be in that top 100 to get a crystal. I didn't think, if we look at the leaderboards right now, I didn't think I was going to be placed where I'm at. I am number 5 in the entire world with 67,000 points. That's huge. You know, that's a really big milestone for me, especially as a new player. As a new content creator to this platform, I love it, and I think that's a great achievement. You see, one day left. It's not over, so I can drop down. But if I drop down, that is okay for me. Now, when it comes to what I want to improve on when it comes to the rank rewards is this. I feel after playing this event for 2 days and after playing the game for a couple of weeks now, that this event is a great addition, but if the rank rewards were just a little bit more spread. So the rank 1 placement, yes, a 5-star is great actually as a top milestone rank reward. But if that can be the top 20, it doesn't have to be 100, 200. I think that's overkill. But if you can stretch that out to the top 20, that ideally would give players more of an incentive to push for those milestones. Because if we look at the leaderboards and we look at the point system, it drops tremendously. Once you get into the 30s, you have a lot of players inside that 30 bracket. But if you can just push, let's say, who's number 20 at the moment? Let's say, I haven't even done this math or research. Number 20 is 30,000 points. Maybe 20... it's a little bit too much. Maybe we say like the top 10. The top 10 seems like ideal, actually. The top 10, based off these points, seems a little bit better situated. The top 10 players, instead of the number one player, the top 10 players get a five-star Oogie Boogie or whatever the compensation is. And that pushes your 11 to 20 players or anybody that's not in the top 10 to kind of like, hey, I'm very, very, very close. Let's actually throw in some orbs inside this event to like refresh or to get more energy to be able to go in and just add more points. And guess what that does to the top 10 players? Once they go and check and they're like, oh, I didn't realize I was in the top 10, but now that I do and I want that five-star Oogie Boogie, I'm gonna refresh, I'm gonna throw some orbs in there as well, and it becomes a competition. And ideally, these leaderboards are competition along with a little bit of a bragging rights, but it's mainly a competition, and it's a visual up-to-date per minute competition. So anybody that scores a point, you can see it immediately where they're at. So I would improve on that. You know, like I said, maybe top 10. I was probably being too generous with top 20 based off these numbers. I want to make this as a wise or kind of like, hey, looking at some numbers, this is where I think it would be a great improvement just for the players, because that gives 9 more people a five-star Oogie Boogie. And then also it allows the game to kind of be more to grow. I want this game to grow. I want this game to be healthy. And if we can feed it some orbs, some cash, then it would become a little bit healthy, stronger game. And I think that would be a great fix. I don't want to say it's broken or damaged, but a great improvement onto the rank rewards. Now, what would we change when it comes to the other ones? Then I would give a 4-star to the remainder, you know, players, and then a 3-star and so on, whether the brackets are done. But I think to push the top players to push for more orbs, because those are the ones that are pushing for more orbs, you know, anybody else in the bottom ranks, I think you giving them as a like reward for you playing the game, for playing or participating, you know, as a 3-star Oogie Boogie, it's really nice. But yeah, that 5-star, if we can stretch that out to the top 10, would be great. Now, the other thing I want to talk about is the strategy. Now, this is not going to happen all the time. This is happening just right now because the game just launched. There is a launch exclusive for $30. To get that point system to be in that top 10 or to be in the top 5 or to be the number one player inside the leaderboards right now for this event, I wouldn't doubt this player is probably spending a little bit of over $1,000 to earn that score and also to earn those amount of points. Whether they had a stash of orbs grinded already and in that account and sitting there really ready to be used, well, let's say he didn't or she didn't, and he used or she used cash to get that those orbs, then you're using a lot of cash to get that, because you're spending over 250 orbs every single time to top off your energy. So at $30, you can just forget all that, save yourself hundreds of dollars, and just give yourself a 4-star orb, Oogie Boogie. Now, the thing about here and the strategy about this is this is an exclusive. This is only a one time. Not all events, if we continue, are gonna be the same. But when it comes to this event and this 4-star, let's say you pick them up here. Let's say you pick them up from the crystals that you've got from the milestones. You can kind of grow your 4-star to become a 5-star. And if you're not into a huge demanding rush to get Oogie Boogie as a 5-star, you're going to be able to pick up Oogie Boogie as a 2, as a 3 throughout just playing the game. And eventually you're going to grow that guy to be a 5-star. So I think honestly now when looking at this offer, it's got 15 days left. The bonus saying 400% value on this offer, I would say because of the event and everything we're seeing, I would definitely say this is a great pickup if you're wanting Oogie Boogie. That's only the only if. If you want Oogie Boogie, I would go and pick this up because the value compared to the amount of orbs and energy you got to spend to get them as a 4-star right now, it's not 30 bucks, guys. It's not 30 bucks in orbs. Now, again, that is just because this is a launch exclusive and it's only a one-time thing. But as we get more, hopefully in the future, events like these will have, different situations. Will they bring back exclusive options? Sorry about that. Now we're back. Will they bring back exclusive options for this? Who knows? But as of now, this is what we're working with. And those are my simple thoughts, guys, when it comes to what where I'm at, again, with the points that I've been able to put towards. This is like my own experience from just days of playing the event and then weeks of playing the game, and the value of the Guardian that's being up for grabs, the value of the actual star level of the Guardian. Now, I'd be interested in knowing your thoughts, and let me know in the comments, how do you feel about this? Do you feel like are you competing in the top, 100? Or are you just kind of like, hey, I enjoy the milestones. I agree with you. Milestones are amazing. And that's all I'm going to do. You know, that's it. That's it. Maybe for another champion. Maybe for another Guardian. Sorry. Oogie Boogie. I can pass. I love it. I love the theme. But not this guy. So let me know in the comments. Hopefully you guys are doing well today. Take care. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.